it now appears that we have two Hawaiian officials that are lying on behalf of Barack Obama. Governor Linda Lingle was interviewed on WABC Radio Sunday night. Here's the clip.
Governor, let me just ask you about the second issue, President Obama's birth certificate. Now, you are expected, and please correct me if I'm mistaken, to sign a bill passed by the legislature that will leave your government agencies alone when it comes to these myriad requests, I think it's like 20 a week, asking to see a copy of President Obama's birth certificate?
It's been an odd situation, Rabbi. You know, during the campaign of 2008, I was actually in the mainland campaigning for Senator McCain. And this issue kept coming up so much in the campaign. And again, I think it's one of those issues that is simply a distraction from the more critical issues that are facing the country. And so I had my health director, who is a physician by background, go personally view the birth certificate in the birth records of the Department of Health. And we issued a news release at that time saying that the president was, in fact, born at Kapi'olani Hospital in Honolulu, Hawaii. And that's just a fact.
Well, the fact is that Dr. Chiyome Fukino did make a press release on October 31st, 2008, but it did not say that Barack Obama was born at Kapi'olani Medical Center in Hawaii, as the governor has just stated. This is the official statement. I'll leave a link in the info box so you can actually go to the state of Hawaii's site and see the press release for yourself. I'll read it for immediate release. October 31st, 2008, statement by Dr. Chiyome Fukino. There have been numerous requests for Senator Barack Hussein Obama's official birth certificate. State law, Hawaii Revised Statutes 338-18, prohibits the release of a certified birth certificate to persons who do not have a tangible interest in the vital records. Therefore, I, as Director of Health for the State of Hawaii, along with the Registrar of Vital Statistics, who has statutory authority to oversee and maintain these type of vital records, have personally seen and verified that the Hawaii State Department of Health has Senator Obama's original birth certificate on record in accordance with state policies and procedures. She then goes on to say, no state official, including Governor Linda Lingle, has ever instructed that this vital record be handled in any manner different from any other vital record in the possession of the state of Hawaii. We've just heard the governor say that she told Chiyome Fukino to go look at the birth certificate and issue a press release saying that Barack Obama was born at the Kapi'olani Medical Center. We have Chiyome Fukino stating that no state official, including the governor, has ever instructed that this vital record be handled in any manner different from any other vital record in possession of the state of Hawaii. And the fact is that it is illegal, according to the disclosure law that Dr. Chiyome Fukino had quoted in this press release. 338-18 says to protect the integrity of vital statistic records, to ensure their proper use, and to ensure the efficient and proper administration of the vital statistic system, it shall be unlawful for any person to permit inspection of or to disclose information contained in the vital statistic records, or to copy or to issue a copy of all or part of any record, except as authorized by this part or by the rules adopted by the Department of Health. Well, there is no rule in the Department of Health that gives the governor the right to override this law and issue a statement stating where Obama was born, nor does she have the authority to tell Dr. Chiyome Fukino to issue a statement stating where Barack Obama was born. Now, we've just heard the governor state on the radio that she did tell Chiyome Fukino to break this law and to tell us where Barack Obama was born. And yet, we have Dr. Chiyome Fukino now lie and say that no state official, including the governor, has ever instructed her to handle that record any differently than any other record, which would mean to keep this law and not to disclose any information contained in the vital record. So we have proof here that both of them have been lying, covering each other up, and lying on the behalf of Barack Obama. Thanks for listening.
And that's just a fact.